Distinguished dignitaries on the dais, conference participants. I'd like to take this opportunity to compliment ICT Academy for having taken up this initiative of taking an issue like the future of work. Because while it's being debated, many times I feel it's with a little negative connotation, saying that the Indian IT industry used to recruit 160,000 grads into the industry. With the change happening, will that number go down? I'd like to leave with the first premise, saying that it might be true if you're talking about a $1 trillion industry growing at 3-4%, with the way in which work is getting impacted, it could sort of face a slower number of people coming into the industry. But the fact is, the world is changing. The ICT industry is no more what it was in the past. Clearly, if you look at a space like advertising, more and more paper-based advertising is moving into digital advertising, and that's becoming an essential part of the ICT industry itself. Or if you take some things which you and me experience every day, hospitality industry. Just to give you an example, OYO Rooms, which was started by Ritesh Agarwal, in 3 years, on revenue terms, is equivalent to the Taj Group this year. So, in a way, we are not talking about the same industry. We're talking about a much more bigger, enlarged industry which is encompassing other industries. So, the first premise I'd like to leave with is there's a lot more optimism. There's so much more to be done. The second point which I'd like to leave before you for your thought is that the pace of adoption of technology is rapidly shrinking. Many of us today are users of smartphones. It took about 12 years for smartphones to get about 10 million consumers. But if you take a game like Angry Birds, it got 10 million users exactly in 5 days. So the pace of adoption of technology is diminishing rapidly. Not only is the pace of adoption of technology diminishing rapidly, the impact on productivity, many of the earlier speakers talked about it, is dramatically increasing. IT Secretary talked about how Amazon has improved warehouse productivity by 4 times. But today's technology and what will happen in the future will not just impact productivity by 4 times, it will probably impact it by 100 or 200 times. So that is something which you need to keep mindful of, because it's not going to happen in the future. Many of what we are talking about in terms of the future of work and impacting is going to happen today or tomorrow. So we need to be cognizant of that, and the impact on productivity would be substantively higher. And many times when we talk about the future of work, we tend to think just of technology. We think of artificial intelligence, machine learning, augmented reality, virtual reality. But the fact is, you need to think of future of work with the future workforce, because the future workforce is very different. The millennials are very much a multitasking workforce. Their idea of a job is not what many of us, or many of me who are in a very different generation, thought about. There's no concept of a lifelong employment. Many of them want to work in areas which they like and then probably do something which is their hobby. So they're driven more by self-learning. And to that extent, I think teaching methods also need to change, where you support self-learning, which are probably driven by technology. So as teachers, I think from teaching, you need to move into more what we would call assisted teaching or more mentorship, which is what really the future workforce needs. So the third premise which I'd like to leave with it is, don't think of just how the work will change, but also think of what is it that the future workforce will expect from teachers, which is really driven by self-learning and a notion of teaching to mentorship as being far more important. So I do believe that teaching has to become far more immersive. Many of the speakers before talked about it. How do people do stuff? How do they experiment? How do they fail and learn from it is necessarily going to become way more important. Having said this, because there are going to be many more industries which are going to become part of ICT, I do believe while repetitive tasks, which are mundane, might get replaced by automation, by artificial intelligence, There are going to be many more new jobs which will get created. The fact is they'll require new competencies. So it's important for organizations like ICT Academy to play a key role in trying to understand what are the new jobs which are going to get created, what are the new skills and competencies required for that, and work with the industry and work with the government to create those new skills ahead of time. And since many of you are teachers, I happened to read a speech by Dr. Raghuram Rajan, I think a couple of days back in Kochi, where this question was raised to him, because he himself is a professor at the Booth School of Business. Someone asked him, saying, with all this artificial intelligence and machine learning, do you think professors will be replaced? I think there's a reality that a lot of what you teach in terms of very mundane, repetitive things, which means on basics of thermodynamics, is there a need for a professor to teach that in class? I think 5 years down the line, I don't think that need will be there. You'll probably, many of you would have known Sophia the humanoid, which a company in Hong Kong has built. There could be James, or there could be Anbumani, who's a robo who would be teaching thermodynamics in class. But the fact is, at the end of the day, human intelligence and intuition cannot be replaced. There is certainly a role, and it probably needs to be structured very differently, where you're going to teach people in terms of immersive learning experiences. You're going to teach people like Professor Bhaskar talked in terms of how they're learning through internship. So your role as teachers will change. The expectation of the future workforce will change, and we need to be cognizant of that and change ourselves. And clearly, I would see more optimism in terms of more number of jobs getting created, newer opportunities which will really help all of us drive productivity and improvement in a much more bigger scale. Thank you.